on Raglan Road of an autumn day, I saw her first and knew that her dark hair would weave a snare that I might one day rue. I saw the danger and I passed along the enchanted way, and I said, let grief be a fallen leaf at the dawning of the day. On Grafton Street in November, we tripped lightly along the ledge of a deep ravine where can be seen the worth of passion's pledge, the queen of hearts still making tart, and I not making hay. Oh, I loved too much, and by such is happiness thrown away. I gave her gifts of the mind, I gave her the secret sign that's known to the artists who have known the true gods of sound and the stone, and word and tint without stint. I gave her poems to say with her own name there and her own dark hair like clouds over fields of May. On a quiet street where old ghosts meet, I see her walking now away from me so hurriedly. My reason must allow that I had loved not as I should a creature made of clay. When the angel woos, the clay he'd lose his wings at the dawn of day.
Said the fine old woman, what did I have? This proud old woman did say, I had four green fields, each each one was a jewel. But strangers came and tried to take them from me. But my fine, strong sons, they fought to save my jewels. They fought and they died. And that was my grief, said she. Long time ago, said the fine old woman. Long time ago, this proud old woman did say, there was war and death, plundering and pillage, my children starved by mountain, valley and stream, and their way they reach the very heavens, and my full green fields ran red with their blood, said she. How have I now, said the fine old woman. What have I now, this proud old woman did say, I have four green fields, one of them's in bondage, in strangers' hands, that tried to take it from me. But my sons have sons as brave as were their fathers, and my four green fields will bloom once again, said she. And my four green fields will bloom once again, said she.
Thank you.
Prison wall, I heard a young girl calling, Michael, they are taking you away, for you stole Trevelyan's corn, so the young might see the morn. Now the prison ship lies waiting in the bay. Lo,
cry. Where once we watched the small free birds fly, our love was on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. By a lonely prison wall, I heard a young man calling. Nothing matters to Mary when you're free. Against the famine and the crown, I rebel, they ran me down. Now you must raise our child with dignity. Low lie the fields of Athenry, where once we watched the small flea birds fly. Our dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. By a lonely harbor wall, she watched the last star falling. As the prison ship sailed out against the sky, but she'll wait and hope and pray for love in Botany Bay. But it's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. The small flea birds fly. Our love was on the wing. We had dreams and songs to sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry. It's so lonely round the fields of Athenry.
Gas yard wall, and we laughed through the smoke and the smell. Going home in the rain, running up the dark lane, past the jail and down behind the fountain. Those were high days in so many, many ways, in the town I loved so well. In the early morning, the shirt factory horn called women from Cregan, the moor and the bog, while the men on the dole, played a mother's role, fed the children, and then trained the dog. And when times got tough, there was just about enough, but they saw it through without complaining. For deep inside was a burning pride in the town I loved so well. There was music there in the dairy air, like a language that we all could understand. I remember the day that I earned my first pay, when I played in a small pickup band. There I spent my youth, and to tell you the truth, I was sad to leave it all behind me, for I'd learned about life, and I found a wife in the town I loved so that hangs on to every breeze. Now the army's installed by that old gas yard wall, and the damned barbed wire gets higher and higher. With their tanks and their guns, oh my God, what have they done the town I loved so well? Now the music's gone, but they carry on, for their spirit's been bruised, never broken. They will not forget, but their hearts are set on tomorrow and peace once again. For what's done is done, and what's won is won, and what's lost is lost and gone forever. I can only pray for a bright, brand new day in the town I love so well. Dearest Mother, I am writing just
just to say I won't be home. There is something that I have to do, and I must do alone. They took me and they put me in this lonely prison cell. Tonight my thoughts are with you as I say my last farewell. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget and Michal. I have no words to tell you how much I'll miss you all. Although I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. Dearest brother, won't you take good care of all the folks for me? Go home to Rathfarnham on the day they set you free. I was happy when you stood by me in all that we've been through. No one has ever had so true a brother such as you. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget and Michal. I have no words to tell you how much I'll miss you all. Although I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. Dearest mother, it's so very sad that now we have to part. To understand the reasons that trouble your poor heart, I have told you since I was a boy it was my destiny die a true brave soldier, so that one day you'd be free. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget and Michal. I have no words to tell you how much I'll miss you all. Although I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. In my final letter, I will bid my last farewell.
I saw a horse outside the door where my old horse should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, will you kindly tell to me who owns that horse outside the door where my old horse should be? Daddy, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and still you cannot see. That's a lovely sow that me mother sent to me. Well, it's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, but a saddle on a sow sure I never saw before. And as I went home on a Tuesday night, as drunk could be, I saw a coat behind the door where my old coat should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, will you kindly tell to me Who owns that coach behind the door where my old coach should be? Dilly, you drunk, you silly old fool. Still you cannot see. That's a woolen blanket that my mother sent to me. Well, it's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more. But buttons in a blanket sure I never saw before. Then as I went home on a Wednesday night, as drunk could be, I saw my pipe upon the chair where my own pipe should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, will you kindly tell to me who owns that pipe upon the chair where my old pipe should be? Dilly, you drunk, you silly young fool. Still you cannot see. That's a lovely tin whistle that my mother sent to me. Well, it's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more. But tobacco in a tin whistle, sure I never saw before. And as I went home on a Thursday night, as drunk could be, I saw two boots beneath the bed where my old boots should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, will you kindly tell to me who owns them boots beneath the bed where my old boots should be? Billy, you drunk, you silly old fool. Still you cannot see. They're two lovely geranium pots me mother sent to me. Well, it's many a day I've travelled 100 miles or more. But laces in geranium pots I never saw before. And as I went home on a Friday night, as drunk could be, I saw a head inside the bed where my old head should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, will you kindly tell to me who owns that head with you in the bed where my old head should be? Billy, you're drunk, you silly old fool. Still you cannot see. That's a baby boy that me mother sent to me. Well, it's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more. But a baby boy with his whiskers on sure I never saw before. La 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 la.
Well, in a neat little town they call Belfast, the friendliest of trade I was found. Many an hour's sweet happiness have I spent in that neat little town. A sad misfortune came over me, which caused me to stray from the land. Far away from my friends and relations, betrayed by the black velvet band. It's happy now. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I called her the queen of the land. And her hair, it hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. I took a stroll down Broadway, meaning the block for the stay. When who should I meet but this pretty fair maid, from a traipsing along the highway. She was both fair and handsome, her neck it was just like a swan, and her hair it hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. Everybody, her eyes they shone like diamonds. I thought her the queen of the land, and her hair it hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. I took a stroll with this pretty fair maid and a gentleman passing us by. Well, I knew she meant the doing of him by the love in her roguish black eye. Oh, but she took from his pocket and placed it right into my hand. And the very first thing that I said was, access to the black velvet band. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I thought her the queen of the land. Judge, he says to me,
young man, your case it is proven clear. We'll give you 7 years penal servitude to be spent far away from the land, far away from your friends and companions, betrayed by the black velvet band.
Everybody,
our eyes they shone like diamonds, like butter.
On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet cove of Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of clay for the grand city hall in New York. 'Twas a wonderful craft, she was rigged fore and aft, and oh, how the wild winds drove her. She stood several blasts, she had 27 masts, and they called her the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags, we had 2 million barrels of stone. We had 3 million sides of old blind horses' hides, we had 4 million barrels of bone. We had 5 million hogs, we had 6 million dogs, we had 7 million barrels of porter. We had 9 million bales of old nanny goat tails, all on board of the Irish Rover. There was old Mickey Coote, who played hard on his flute when the ladies lined up for the set. He would tootle with skill for each sparkling quadrille, till the dancers were flutered and bet. With his smart, witty talk, he was cock of the walk, as he rowed the dames under and over. When he took up his stance, they all knew at a glance that he sailed in the Irish Rover. There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee, there was Hogan from County Tyrone, and Mickey McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a chap from Westmeath named Malone. There was Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. There was Dolan from Clare, just as strong as the bear, all on board of the Irish Rover. We had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out, and the ship lost its way in the fog. Then a whale of a crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. Then the ship struck a rock, oh Lord, what a shock. The boat, it was turned right over, turned 9 times around, then the old dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rover.
You may travel far, far from your own native home, far away o'er the mountains, far away o'er the foam, but of all the fine places that I have ever seen, so there's none to compare with the cliffs of Dunedin. It's a nice place to be on a bright summer's day, watching all the wild flowers that never do decay, all the hare and lofty pheasants are plain to be seen, making home for their young round the cliffs of Dunedin. Then take a view o'er the mountains, fine sights you'll see there. See the high rocky mountains on the west coast of Clare, o'er the towns of Tilkey and Kilrush they can be seen. From the high rocky slopes around the cliffs of Dunedin, then fare thee well to Dunedin, fare thee well for a while. And to all the fine people I'm leaving behind, to the streams and the meadows where late I have been, and the high rocky slopes around the cliffs of Dunedin.
And I shall hear for ye will bend and tell me that you love me, and I shall sleep in peace until you come to me.
Thank you.
Tim Finnegan lived in Walking Street, a gentleman Irish mighty odd. He had a brogue both rich and sweet, and to rise in the world he carried a hod. But Tim and a bit of a timorous way, well, I love the liquor he was born, and to send him on his way each day, he'd drop in the cradle every morn. Why, pull it down, will you dance to your partner around the floor with your trotters shake? Isn't it the truth? I tell you, lots of fun at Finnegan's wake. Now one morning Tim was rather full, his head felt heavy which made him shake. He fell off the ladder and he broke his skull, then they carried him home, his corpse to wake. Oh, they wrapped him up in a nice clean sheet, they laid him out upon the bed, with a bottle of whiskey at his feet and a bottle of porter at his head. Whack, pull it down, will you dance to your partner around the floor with your thunder's shake? Isn't it the truth? I tell you, lots of fun at Finnegan's wake. And his friends assembled at the wake, and Mrs. Finnegan called for lunch. Well, first she brought them tea and cake, then pipes, tobacco and brandy punch. Then the widow Malone began to cry, "Ah, such a lovely corpse did you ever see? Must it him aboard and why did you die? Will you howl your gobs as Molly McGee? Whack, pull it down, will you dance to your partner around the floor with your totter's shake? Isn't it the truth? I tell you, lots of fun at Finnegan's wake." Oh, well, Mary Murphy took up the job. Ah, Biddy, she you're wrong, I'm sure. Well, Biddy fetched her a belt and a gob and left her sprawling on the floor. A civil war did then engage. 'Twas woman to woman and man to man. Shillelagh law was all the rage, and a row and a ruction it soon began. What for the now, will you dance to your partner around the floor with your trotter's shake? Isn't it the truth? I tell you, lots of fun at Finnegan's wake. Oh, Tim Maloney ducked his head when a bottle of whiskey flew at him. He ducked and landing on the bed, the whiskey scatters over Tim. Me daddy revives and see how he rises, Tim Finnegan rising in the bed, saying, "Twiddle your whiskey around like blazes. Be the toilet and jazz, do you think I'm dead?" Whack, pull it down, you dance to your partner around the floor with your trotter's shake. Isn't it the truth? I tell you, lots of fun at Finnegan's wake. How would you know one game ball?
That he came in from the wintry cold and damp, a giant of a man in an oilskin coat and the bundle that told he was a tramp. He stood at the bar and he called a pint, then turned and gazed at the fire. On a night like this, to be safe and dry is my one and only desire.
So here's to those that are dead and gone, the friends that I love dear. And here's to you, and I bid you adieu, St. Donegal, Danny's been here, me boys, Donegal, Danny's been here.
Then in a voice that was hushed and low, he said, "Listen, I'll tell you a tale. How a man of the sea became a man of the roads, and never more will set sail. I fished out a post and Killybegs, hard glass and Baltimore. But the cruel sea has beaten me, and I'll end my days on the shore.
So
here's to those that are dead and gone, the friends that I love dear. And here's to you, and I'll bid you adieu, saying, Donegal, Daddy's been here, me boys, Donegal, Daddy's been here.
One fateful night in the wind and the rain, we set sail from Killybeg's town. There were five of us from sweet Donegal and one from County Down. We were fishermen who worked the sea and never counted the cost. But I never thought ere that night was done that my fine friends would all be lost.
So here's to those that are dead and gone, the friends that I love dear. And here's to you, and I'll bid you adieu, saying, Donegal, Daddy's been here, me boys, Donegal, Daddy's been here.
Then the storm, it broke and drove the boat to the rocks about 10 miles from shore. As we fought the tide, we hoped inside to see our homes once more. Then we struck a rock and holed a bow, and all of us knew that she'd go down. So we jumped right into the icy sea and prayed to God we wouldn't drown. But the raging sea was rising still as we struck out for the land. And she fought with all her cruelty to claim that gallant man. By St. John's Point in the early dawn, I dragged myself on the shore. And I cursed the sea for what she'd done, and vowed to sail her nevermore.
So here's to those that are dead and gone, the friends that I love dear. And here's to you, and I'll be you and you, St. Donegal, Danny's been here.
Town, there lived a girl fairer than the flower I am wearing. Rose Donahue, all fresh and new, and I loved her past all care. And there she goes, my rings and rose. In God's garden there's none rarer. And there she goes, my rings and rose. Dublin town has seen fairer, sweet 17, my seamstress queen. She's no bigger than a thimble, soft satin skin. And there she goes, my rings and rose. In God's garden there's none rarer. And there she goes,
has seen none fairer. 3 yards of lace, I'll walk with grace, and the golden ring she's asking. Safe and slow, but still I know that her love is everlasting. And there she goes, my rings and rose in God's garden there.
Ship was anchored on a bright St. Patrick's Day. On the quay, a lass was sighing for her lover going away. In her hand she held an emblem, and its parting leaves were three, and her parting words were, darling, look at these and think of me. 3-leaved shamrock, I adore thee, your 3 leaves I'd long to free. When there's brighter days in Ireland, I'll come home and marry thee. Just before the ship had started, as she held her hand on mine, just before that we had parted, she looked with loving eyes so kind. To my coat she pinned an emblem, and its parting leaves were 3, and her parting words were, darling, look at these and think of me. 3-leaved shamrock, I adore thee, your 3 leaves I'd long to free. When there's brighter days in Ireland, I'll come home and marry thee. But tonight I am an exile, far from home and far from thee. next in my heart I'll wear your token. Love, no matter where I be, and although the seas divide us, and your face I'll never see, when there's brighter days in Ireland, I'll come home and marry thee. Three-leaved shamrock, I adore thee. Your three leaves I'd long to free, when there's brighter days in Ireland, I'll come home and marry thee.
Last night as I lay dreaming of pleasant days gone by, me mind went bent on rambling to Ireland I did fly. I stepped on board a vision and I followed with the will, till next I came to anchor at the cross in Spansel Hill. It been on the 23rd of June, the day before the fair, when Ireland's sons and daughters and friends assemble there. The young, the old, the brave and the bold came their duty at the parish church in Clooney, a mile from Spansel Hill. I went to see me neighbours, to see what they might say. The old ones were all dead and gone, the young ones turning grey. But I met the tailor Quigley, he's as bold as ever still. Ah, he used to make me breeches when I lived in Spansel Hill. First and only love, she's as white as any lily, gentle as a dove, and she threw her arms around me, saying, Johnny, I love you still. Ah, she's now the farmer's daughter and the pride of Spansel Hill. I dreamt I held and kissed her, as in the days of yore. Ah, Johnny, you're only joking, as many's the time before. Then the cock, he crew in the morning, he crew
both loud and shrill. I awoke in California, many miles from Spansel Hill.
Was in the year of 39, when the sky was full of lead, when Hitler was heading for Poland and Paddy for Holyhead. Come all you pincher laddies and you long distance men, don't ever work for McAlpine, for Wimpy or John Lang. For you'll stand behind the mixer till your skin is turning to tan, and they'll say good on you, Paddy, with your boat fare in your hand. Oh, the crack was good in Cricklewood, and they wouldn't leave the crown, with the glasses flying and biddies crying, sure Paddy was going to tell. Oh, mother dear, I'm over here, I never will come back. What keeps me here is the rake of beer, the ladies and the crack. Oh, as down that land came McAlpine men, with their shovels slung behind them. 'Cause in the pub they drank the sob, and up in the spike you'll find them. They sweated blood and they washed down mud with pints and quarts of beer. And now we're on the road again with McAlpine Fusiliers. I'm stiff to the skin with a darky flint, way down upon the Isle of Rain. With the horse-faced tool, then I knew the rule, no money if you stop for rain. When McAlpine God with a well-filled hod, your shoulders cut to bits and seared. And woe to he went to look for tea with the McAlpine's Fusiliers. I remember the day that the Bear O'Shea fell into a concrete stairs. What the horse face said when he saw him dead, well, it wasn't what the rich called prayers. I'm a navvy short with the one record that reached on to my ears. When the going is rough, well, you must be tough with the McAlpine Fusiliers. Till the sweat it has had me pet with a Russian, Czech and Pole. Unshuttering jams up in the hydro dams or underneath the Thames in a hole. I've grafted hard and I've got me cards and many a ganger's fist across me ears. If you pride in your life, don't join by Christ with McAlpine's Fusiliers. Thank you.
Tell me, ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. I pulled my hair, I stole my comb. Well, that's all right when I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is the belle about the city. She is a curtain, only three. Please, when you tell me, who is she? Albert Mooney says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for. They're up on the door, they ring on the bell. Tsunami, fool of, are you well? Hope she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. Oh, Johnny Murray says she'll die if she doesn't get the fowl of the roving night. And the wind and the rain, the hay blow high, snow can tumble in from the sky. She's as nice as apple pie, she'll get her own lad by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell him of when she comes home. Let them all come as they will, for it's Albert Mooney she'll still. Now the grass is growing, water's flowing, a free and easy way. But give me enough of the fine, no stuff with brood near Galway Bay. And policemen all from Donegal, from Sligo, Leitrim too, we'd give them the slip if they take a sip of the real old Mountain Dew. Hey, deedle-lay-de-lum-de-lee-de-lay-de-lum-de-lee-um-de-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-
smoke and smell, they can plainly tell there's Potch and Brew nearby. For it fills the air with an odor rare betwixt both me and you. When home you strode, you can take a bowl or the bucket of the Mountain Dew. Hey, diddle diddle lum, diddle 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 diddle. Now learned men use the pen of a road, your praises high. A sweet poteen from air and green, a steel from weed and rye. Throw away your pills, it'll cure all ills, a Christian heathen a Jew. Take off your coat and grease your throat with the real old Mountain Dew. Hi deedle diddle lum diddle 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 lum diddle yum diddle hi day. Hi deedle diddle lum diddle 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 lum diddle yum diddle hi day. I've courted yards in Blarney, in Kentuck and in Killarney, in Passage and in Queenstown, I taste the cove of Clark. Goodbye to all this pleasure, for I'm going to take me leisure. Aye, the next time you'll hear from me, be a letter from me yard. So goodbye, machine jerkin, I'm sick and tired of working. The more I'll ding the praise, no longer I'll be fooled. For sure, my name is Carney, I'll be off to California, where instead of digging praties, I'll be digging lumps of gold. Goodbye to all the boys at home, I'm sailing far across the foam. Pray to make me fortune in far America, for there's gold and money plenty for the poor and for the gentry. And when I come back again, I never more will stay. So goodbye, machine jerkin, I'm sick and tired of working. The more I'll ding the praties, no longer I'll be fooled. For sure, my name is Carney, I'll be off to California, where instead of digging praties, I'll be digging lumps of gold.
In rugged hills on the coast of Donegal, and the fishermen are hardy, brave and free. And the big Atlantic swell is a thing I know right well, as the fight to take a living from the sea. With the pleasant road and sea, and the herring running free, and the fleet are gliding gently through the foam. When the boats are loaded down, there be singing in the town, when the boys of Killybanks come rolling home.
Now you're heading out to sea, and the wind is blowing free, and you cast your nets as rain begins to fall. But the sun comes riding high, and the clouds will soon go by, and maybe today you'll take a bumper haul.
With a pleasant road and sea, and the herring running free, and the fleet are gliding gently through the foam. When the boats are loaded down, there'll be singing in the town, when the boys of Killybanks come rolling home.
Now the weather's blowing rough, and the work is very tough, and the ropes and raise the wells upon your hands. But you'll never leave the sea, for whoever you may be, when it's in your blood, it's hard to live on land.
with a pleasant rolling sea and the herring running free, and the flea frog gliding gently through the foam. When the boats are loaded down, there'll be singing in the town when the boys of Killybags come rolling home. There's purple on the hills, and there's green them by the shore, and the sun has spread its gold upon the sea, and there's silver down below where the herring fishes go, and we catch them, there'll be gold for you and me. With a pleasant rolling sea and the herring running free, and the fleet all gliding gently through the foam, when the boats are loaded down, there'll be singing in the town when the boys of Killybags come rolling home. When the boys of Killybags come rolling home.
There's one fair county in Ireland with memories so glorious and grand, where nature has lavished her bounty. It's the orchard of Erin's green land. I love its cathedral city, once founded by Patrick so true. Ah, but there in the heart of his bosom lie the ashes of Brian Boru. It's my own Irish home, far across the pole. Although I've oft times left it in foreign lands to roam, no matter where I wander, through cities near or far, sure my heart's at home in all Ireland, in the county.
Far across yonder blue lies a true fairy land, where the sea ripples over its shingle and sand, where the gay honeysuckle is luring the bee, and the green glens of Ann are calling to me. If only you knew how the lamp of the moon turns a grey Irish bay to a silver loom, you'd imagine the picture of heaven it would be, where the green calling to me. I just stepped in to see you all, I'll only stay a while. I want to see how you're getting on, I want to see you smile. I'm happy to be back again to greet you all and all, for there's no place else on earth just like the homes of Donegal. For there's no place else on earth just like the homes of Donegal.